Welcome to Joyce Fashion Designing Home. Today I want to be teaching you how to make a Zahra cap. Zahra cap is in vogue now. So what am I going to be using? You're going to be using any fabric. You can use any fabric. You can use Ankara. The Ankara you make for, maybe you make dress, you remain some Ankara then use it for Zahra cap. Whichever dress, but I'm using satin fabric for it. So we're going to be measuring 25 by 21. The reason why I use 25 for you, this side is for the round head. The reason why I use 25 here is because this material is not stretch material. But if you're using stretch material, you will use 23. So you measure 25 by 21. And you're using this, you can use hard wording for it. And this is what I'm using is a paper steel. This is hard paper steel, hard one. So for this 25 here, you will fold this into two. This is 25 is where the round head, the head circumference. So you make sure you fold it into two like this. Fold it into two like this and notch the middle part. You notch the middle part and take the gum stay and notch the middle part of it. So you have notched it like this. This is how it will be, and you notch this side. You open it. You open it and take the place in notch. Look for the gum side and. Remember, you're not going to gum it. Fold it inside. Fold it inside. And fold it inside like this. And take it to your machine and sew it. It down. So I'm going to be taking it on the machine now and make a stitch on it. So the gum stay is the length of the gum stay is 18 inches by 2.5. You can use 3 inches, but in this tutorial I'm using 2.5. That's 18 inches by 2.5. So I've made the stitching, and then I've sewn it straight down. I use this yellow thread so that you can see where I sew. So we made the sewing straight down to this place. So after that, I'm going to be folding it. Remember, after folding this, after sewing this thing, if you measure the length now to remain 18 inches. So you're going to fold it like this. Fold it like this. Use pin to hold it down first. Still the hair circumference. Use a thread and make a gather stitch. And before that, this is what you're going to do. From this up this place. Let me take it like this. After folding it like this, take it, bring it down to this side, and make a curve with it. Make a curve in here, this way here. Make a curve like this. From this place, just make a curve. Just make a curve like this. Not to this side here. And use scissors to trim it. Going to take it to the machine now and sew it. I was going to sew it straight down here. Make it go straight down like this. And I'll come and sew it. Sew this round. Sew it like I said. You sew it. You see this before you sew this place, you will put it to and put it on your head, whether it will empty very well. But remember I said if it is straight material, it's 23 you will make it. Because it's not straight material, you're using 25 to add sewing allowance. Let's say you're sewing, you're going to sew out that sewing allowance, or another 1 inch or 2 inches. Later, use the scissors and trim it out, and trim the excess out. So you sew out that 2 inches or 1 inch out. After that, you trim the excess. Remember what I said. Make sure the length, the round head, 25 by 21. After that, you sew it like that. After folding it into two like this, maybe I notch it, I notch the estate. Now, after that, you sew that place the way I join it. When I folded it, just sew it straight down like this. Sew it, fold the curve round to this place. So, I'm going to be making a gather stitch on it. You sew it for the gather stitch. Take your needle, make it start making a gather stitch on it. Make a gather stitch like this. Make a gather stitch to the ending. Let me explain this place very well. This gather stitch I make here, if you're making this gather stitch, you want to make it for ladies. Like this one now. I made this gather stitch up to this upside here. So if you want it to gather to this or to give this design, this type of design like this. So you can take this design up here. But if you're making it for men, you don't need to take it to this upper side. Just stop it for this place like this. I've already made the gather stitch from that place. Like I said, if you're making it for ladies, you take it to this upside. If you just want this, if you want the design, it's not necessary. If you want the design, you can make the gather stitch up to this mouth side. But if you're making it for men or even for ladies, you may not like the gather stitch up to this mouth piece. It depends your choice. So after that, you sew it tight here. Stitches 3 to 4 times. Make sure that you stitch very well. Tight very well. Just tight it very well so that it should be okay for you. So you see, this is how to make Zahra card. It comes in different form. Done with this. After that, you come on this side. This is how it will be. This is our Zahra card. The Zahra card is ready. That's what I was talking about. If you want it to have a style, as it is mass side, you can take it up to that. So this is how to make Zahra cap. Try and give it a try and see how it will come out. This is how it looks. Our Zahra cap is ready. Look at it. It's very fine. Make yours. It's for both men and female. Anybody can put it on. you will not even use up to 1 year to make this tie. So this is how it is. Thanks for watching. Welcome to Joycee Fashion Designing Group. God bless you.